The Center for Integrated Nanotechnologies, or CINT, is one of five nanoscience user facilities that's funded by the Office of Science. CINT's thrust is around integration of nanocomponents. So how can you take an individual nanostructure, combine it with other materials and systems to actually make it so it impacts the macroscopic world?
The main mission of the center is to drive nanotechnology, understanding, doing the science, everything related to nanotechnology and nanoscience. This center is basically a public place. So anybody that has a great idea in nanoscience or nanotechnology, they write a relatively short proposal, 2 pages, and then they can access all the resources we have here.
We are split between 2 national laboratories, so Los Alamos National Laboratory and Sandia National Laboratories.
There's a number of different research areas that we have. Nanomechanics and electrical systems, there's soft and biological systems, there's nanophotonics and optics, and there's computational.
My laboratory here at CINT, we focus on in situ characterization of nanomaterials in environmental conditions. So this is in situ electron microscopy, so we can study electrical properties of materials, mechanical properties of materials. We can expose materials to gas environments, to a sealed liquid environment that's at atmosphere. And so a lot of what I've been doing is trying to correlate the structure property relationship of nanomaterials or nanoscale processes. And so if people have systems that they're trying to work on or interfaces they're looking to understand at very high resolution, then we have this site-specific capability to try to get a mechanistic understanding of those processes.
The nerve and heart-related disease influence millions of people's health all over the world. The deaths related to the nerve and heart disease constitute more than 50% of deaths of human beings in the last 50 years. To understand how a single neural worker in a neural network or what's the relationship of the cardiomyocyte activity with the heart disease is very important for the disease diagnosis and drug development to treat them. We developed a new hybrid integrated platform that offers nanowire on a lead approach, which enables independent electrical addressability, is scalable, and has large spatial resolution.
My main work for nano devices is the preparation or synthesis of heterostructures at nano and sub-micrometer scale. So heterostructures is composed of different materials. There are lots of combinations. So I want to bring some emergent properties of materials by making heterostructures. In these days, really interesting material in nanoscience community is two-dimensional materials such as graphene, hexagonal boron nitride. I want to combine the emerging two-dimensional materials and the conventional semiconductors. We can take advantage for emerging properties of two-dimensional materials and establish processing techniques for conventional semiconductors.
My work focused on the understanding of contact formation between metal and semiconductor nanowires and utilizing this understanding to engineer better transistors that are smaller, faster, more efficient and reliable. Nanomaterials, especially nanowires, are promising building blocks for the next generation of electronic devices. The metal and the semiconductor contact is one of the most critical factors limiting the device performance. Our work will contribute to the understanding and engineering of low resistance and thermally stable alloyed contact to those nanoscale transistors.
CINT is an excellent hub for nanoscience research, so we've done a good job of connecting users with other users actually. So if we find one capability that's good for a certain user or one material that's good for a certain project, then we can expand that out and help really create a community.
This past decade, there's been a lot of focus on developing new nanoparticles, nanowires. And the future is now about integrating. How do you bring them together and make these materials or systems that impact the world?
The beginning was scaling materials down, understanding what happens if you make the world small and materials change. But for the future, especially quantum information science, how can you use individual atoms to do computing? And how do you take that knowledge that has been created over the last 15, 20 years in nanoscience and bring it to the next level of complexity?